channel is photogenic in style. Can you believe it? I've just reached 100 subscribers. I am so grateful, and I want to say thank you to all of you supporting me to this point. I know it's only 100, but for someone like me who's just starting in YouTube, this is beyond expectations. Thank you so much to my friends, to my families, to my new friends who's just discovered my channel, and I hope I can continue to contribute to this community and share with you all things in style. Given that it's a special edition, being my 100 subscriber video, I thought it's also timely to share with you my entire Dior Oblique collection. My obsession started when Maria Grazia Chiori reimagined the oblique pattern through the small saddlebags and shoes. Since then, I bought a few things as part of my collection because I love the pattern. I also read a little bit about the history of the Dior Oblique, and apparently this pattern was created by Marc Bohan in 1967 and released to the public in 1969. As you can imagine, there's over 51 years of history of this beautiful pattern. I hope you enjoyed this video because I love these items so much. And I know some of you may have these items as well. Just share with me your experiences in terms of where to wear and things that I'm about to show you. I actually have a little list on what they are because I want to tell you the exact name of these items. And if you have any questions about the items that I'm about to show you, feel free to write your comments below, and I'm happy to answer any questions you may have. The first item that I'm about to show you is my small box, and it is the Dior bracelet set, which I bought in Dubai. I like this bracelet because it was one of the original bracelet sets that was released, and it's still really cool to date, and I can wear it with any type of casual clothes or even dresses if you accessorize nicely. And the second one is the walk-in Dior shoes in blue Dior Oblique embroidered canvas. I also bought this in Dubai, but it's a beautiful shoe and really stylish. The next one is, this is my Dior Oblique stole or scarf, which I've never worn because I live in Singapore and it's always hot in this place. I plan to wear it in Melbourne this year, but because of COVID, I'm never gonna wear it until I go to a winter colder place. But beautiful scarf, it's made of wool and cashmere. Next one is, this is the original Dior book tote in oblique large. What's so special about this is because I've had it embroidered and personalized. I bought this in Marina Bay Sands in Singapore. They had a Dior Oblique exhibition in 2019. Part of that exhibition were artisans in-house. So instead of waiting weeks of getting this personalized, they were able to do this in a few days. So when I bought it, I've also inserted coin purse, which I have accessorized this bag. This is very small. You can't really put anything here except for $1 or $2 coins. But now with this as an accessory, it goes hand in hand. Next item is this beautiful Dior cloth mules and clogs. Bought this in San Francisco, California in Saks Fifth. It's a heavy piece. If you guys know about clogs, this fashion comes and goes. In my younger years, I had a pair of clogs and I remembered wearing it to the ground. So when I saw this, had to have it, and because it was also on sale, it was a no-brainer. My next item is this Dior Quake pouch, and what I like about this is this D handle, which you can carry as clutch, or if you place a strap like this one, you can wear it as a crossbody. Speaking of the Quake collection, my next item is this Dior Quake belt. I really like it as well because it's not so big and it's good with shorts or jeans. Moving on to the next item is this small Dior book tote in embroidered denim. I did a vlog about this in my previous videos, so I will link that too so you can see my unboxing. Talking about 2020, I need to purchase Dior camp bag. I've been eyeing on this for a while, but I just couldn't pull the trigger, and finally I thought January 1st, 2020, I needed a new bag, and this was the lucky bag. What I like about this is the space inside, is the strap, very easy to adjust. Yeah, so that's my Dior camp bag. I've gone through 11 items already, and before I get into the last one, I hope you're liking this video, enjoying what I'm showing you. If you have any questions about them, as I mentioned, feel free to write your comments below and I'll be happy to answer your questions. And I'd like to hear as well, if you have these items, let me know your experience so we can share our joys of the Dior Oblique. I have one last item to show you. It was my last Dior purchase before the COVID lockdown, and I have just unboxed it. I've never worn it, but I intend to wear it in the coming week. When I decided to buy this, the store didn't have my size anymore, so they had to order it in, and I was very lucky that my client executive Lena from Marina Bay Sands Dior was able to find one pair for me. And this is the Dior Oblique Granville Espadrilles. If you're a shoe lover like me, you know how it feels to have a pair of shoes that you really like and you have. All in all, I've showed you 12 items from my Dior Oblique collection. I think I have everything that I need in terms of this collection. But we'll see. You never know. I hope you enjoyed me showing you all these beautiful things. If you have any questions, let me know. Thank you so much again for watching, and thanks for supporting me. I appreciate your time and your effort in watching these videos. So I hope to see you again with more fabulous things and more unboxings and more vlogs. But for now, please take care. See you next time. Bye. It's a